The Stanley Cup, every player and owner's dream is to clinch it and take it back to the city to celebrate. It's all about pride and seeing the millions of smiles on people's faces. Every team has a different path to get there, none of which are easy, but some teams have had to face more than just adversity to achieve hockey's biggest goal. Over the years, there have been many playoff teams who surprised, and some who barely snuck in. But there have also been some with records that were unheard of for playoff caliber teams, making people question how those teams even took home the cup. The 1997 Detroit Red Wings. Now, hear me out. The Wings would go on to win in 1998 and 2002 with the same group. However, this win was surprising to many, as it posted 94 points after a 132-point season the year before. Also worth mentioning, the Stars would beat them out by 10 points for the Central Division title. So, going into the postseason, some were skeptical, but the Wings came to play, taking down the St. Louis Blues and the Anaheim Ducks to then face off against their biggest rivals in the Colorado Avalanche once again in the Western Conference Final. The Wings would ultimately get their revenge and defeat the Colorado Avalanche, and eventually sweep the Flyers in the Stanley Cup Final to take the cup back to Detroit. Out of all the Wings teams in the 1990s, this team seemed the least likely to take home a title.
And today, it's my pleasure to present the Stanley Cup to Steve Yzerman.
The 1995 New Jersey Devils. A year after they lost in the Eastern Conference Final to the New York Rangers, they were hoping to bounce back and make some noise. And thankfully for them, the 48-game season caused by a lockout would allow unusual teams to get into the playoffs. And one of them happened to be the Devils, as they'd post a record of 22-18-8. Almost going 500. So coming into the postseason, the Devils weren't expected to do much. They'd surprisingly get past the Penguins and Flyers to advance to the Stanley Cup Final, where they'd shockingly take down the juggernaut Detroit Red Wings to take home the franchise's first ever Stanley Cup, the first of many for this upcoming powerhouse. The 2012 Los Angeles Kings, a team still waiting to take home the Stanley Cup, and from the regular season statistics, it looked like another year of waiting. However, at the deadline that season, the Kings would make key transactions that would bolster up the team. The biggest perhaps was acquiring Jeff Carter after already having Mike Richards on the roster. The Kings were 10th in the Western Conference, two seeds away from a playoff spot, with only a month to go in the regular season. That is, until they would go 12-4-3 in their final 19 games, securing the 8th and final playoff seed by losing to San Jose in a shootout. Coming into the playoffs that season, LA played like a completely different team, one that wasn't an ideal 8th seed, as they'd crushed the President's Trophy winning Canucks in 5 games, then sweep the Blues in the next round and beat the Coyotes in 5 games, advancing to the Stanley Cup Final, where they'd face a New Jersey Devils team featuring Ilya Kovalchuk, Zach Parise, and Marty Brodeur. The series would take 6 games, as the Kings would come out as the victor, becoming the first 8th seed in North American professional sports history to win a championship.
A Stanley Cup for Los Angeles. The Kings are the Kings.
The 1938 Chicago Blackhawks. Now, granted, this was during a time where there were little teams in the league, but no one thinks of a Stanley Cup winner, let alone playoff contender, possessing as bad as a record as this club had, only tallying 14 wins in the regular season. 14, going 14-25-9, which was surprisingly enough to surpass the Detroit Red Wings, who had 12 wins. So, obviously, the Blackhawks were expected to get dominated by the Canadiens in the first round, but it didn't turn out that way. They beat the Habs in a best-of-3 series, and then do the same against the New York Americans the next round. And in the Stanley Cup Final, they completed their miracle run, knocking out the Leafs in a best-of-five series to hoist the cup. This team will forever remain the worst to ever win the cup, because 14 wins today would only happen to an expansion team.
The Vegas Golden Knights are headed to the Stanley Cup Final!
Once again, this video takes on the definition of an underdog, as it's always occurring in sports. However, what many can learn from this video, and the teams on the list, is that no matter how big the deficit or how big the gap is, one can always push through and come back to achieve their goal. It's now crunch time in the NHL, as teams are duking it out for the final wild card spots and the chance to take part in postseason play. So, for all we know, another team can end up on this list, but a record doesn't define a team's season. The players do, and all it takes is a little bit of hope to be able to do great things.